Ladies and gentlemen, today is a biggie. After a lot of anticipation from you guys, we are finally getting our hands on a Stage 2 Virtus 1.5 TSI Evo. What's it like to drive? What all is new? And how have they managed to do this? All to talk about in today's episode of Auto Culture. My name is Bhavneet and this is a Stage 2 1.5 TSI Evo Virtus GT. Let's not dilly-dally and get straight into the point. What's under the hood? A 1.5 TSI Evo, just like you would get in a stock car, but there have been quite a few changes. There's a new downpipe, an OEM replacement air filter, and the pièce de résistance is that ECU. What seems like a normal ECU is a completely different computer that has been imported. More to talk about that later. In terms of power, it has gone up from 148 bhp to a claimed 180 to 190 bhp. Mind you, this car has not been dynoed yet, so the torque figures are still a question mark. Before we get to drive the car, let's talk about all of the exterior mods first and then take it for a spin. I've always been a fan of the looks of the Virtus, especially the GT with the blackout touches here and there, like near the tail lamp and the GT badge on the side. Looks really mean. But as fitment merchants like you and me, we had a couple of issues. The ground clearance was ridiculous and even the wheel arches had so much space. But now the owner of this car has actually fixed those issues. Now you're running on Lenzo 17-inch wheels wrapped in Michelin rubber. And you've also are running on coilovers from Gecko, which are completely adjustable, making you fully comfortable with whatever kind of ride you would like. If you want to slam it down, you can actually slam it down more than this. This is running a 30mm drop currently, which I think is the perfect spot between practicality and stance. You've also got a hood that is completely carbon fiber and looks really nice. In terms of the front, I've always liked the double projector headlamps that the Virtus comes with, and overall, the car has always been very elegant and the proportions have been very nice. In black, you can notice all of the creases and bits of change of shape in all over the car, which make the car look so muscular and mean. And I've always said this, if a car needs to look good in black, that means the shape needs to be pretty. And the Virtus is no different. Enough said about the looks, time to get on the driver's seat and see what it's like. Life is all about growth, and while everybody's rate of growth is different, us car guys have a very specific way of marking milestones in our lives, and that is buying a car for ourselves. Now, why not buy yourself the car that you really want from the people that understand you as a car guy? Imagine you're welcoming a new member of the family into your house. You need something practical, smooth, and reliable. Look no further than this 52K run, second owner Q3. Possibly, this could be one of the best deals in the Q3 market right now. Or you've just passed your entrance test with flying colors and dad has told you time to get your car for college. How about this? A 1-liter TSI Polo that is ready for you to put all the mods you want during college. This has only run 32,000 kilometers, making it a very nice deal for a new driver. Now imagine you've finally gotten that promotion after years of work and it's time to get a brand new jazzy car for yourself. How about this? A VRS 230 with just 38,000 kilometers and in pristine condition. So if you're like me and you define the chapters of your life through the cars that you've owned, look no further than TDH Classifieds. Head on to thedrivershub.com/TDHClassifieds and get yourself the car of your dreams.
We'll be right back.
Now, something that you guys don't know is that I have actually driven a 1.5 TSI Virtus of a friend, and I had it for a brief time, and I don't know how to describe it briefly, but you know the days when you don't have breakfast, don't have lunch, go to the office, and then at 5-6 p.m. you're still performing, you're still doing work, but you're just not at your prime. And that's what I felt with the 1.5 TSI Evo, that it was a little tired when it came to its outright performance. This is a different scenario altogether. Now in its stage 2 form, it's like it's had a healthy diet for a couple of weeks. It feels like it's been going to gym, it's more athletic, and thanks to the suspension too, it is much more plush. Now, while it might be a fresh experience, since the throttle response is different and the way it moves is very different, it still isn't a massive difference that you are going to be completely shocked by the way the car performs. Yes, it is different and it is noticeable, but it's not extreme. This is what, in my opinion, the way the Virtus GT should have come from factory. And honestly, let's be honest, the GT badge and the name from factory, it's pretty much namesake. This now feels like a real GT. Talking about how CarMed has managed to bring this car into stage 2, it's actually not that complicated. They have imported an ECU that is OEM, and basically you can bench tune it to whatever your choice is, and it's as good as a normal flash. But yes, the ECU has been replaced. Where it's from, it's somewhere from Europe, and it is an OEM ECU. That's enough hints for you guys. It now pushes around 180-190 bhp, and the way the power is delivered is very similar to how it used to be delivered. The power is mainly up there at 2000-2300 rpm. That's when things start getting rather juicy, and the next step for this car could be a set of brakes, because you are only as fast as you can brake. And currently, when pushing the car, consider this to be a rather fast car. You can definitely overtake very easily. And another good thing is that this full system exhaust actually sounds very nice. There's hardly any drone inside the cabin. It's just the symphony rolling around in the back end, making this a rather enjoyable experience. However, the roads are not letting me enjoy it as much as I would like. Apart from that, the Virtus is starting to slowly become a nicer and nicer platform to own. Yes, it is a little bit more limited than the older generation of engines, but that's something that you're going to have to deal with in the coming future too. All engines are going to get higher and higher compressions from factory, which are going to limit its power and its potential anyway.
Performance aside, I personally think the Virtus has a very good looking interior. It looks sophisticated and simple. The build quality is high, and the finish is premium and robust to the touch. The instrument cluster's display is rather large and crisp, so is the infotainment screen. The AC controls, however, are touch sensitive, making them a little distracting to use while driving, but otherwise, everything else in the cabin is super easy to access and operate while on the move. The ventilated seats work wonders, and the seats themselves are well bolstered for some fun driving. Overall, the interior is fancy and feature-packed. You can definitely pass it off as a premium cabin. Back to the geeky stuff.
Now, this is only stage two. And as you know, forced induction hasn't been played with in this car. So, a turbo upgrade could definitely change the way the car behaves, and depending on the dimensions of the turbo, we can really see some difference in behavior too. But as of now, the car is just more enjoyable to drive and a bit more involving. What I found really impressive is that Code 6 and Carmel are not being greedy about this. It costs 90,000 rupees to get a brand new ECU, a TCU Stage 2 and an ECU Stage 2 remap. So it is rather value for money, considering that you are getting a brand new computer to the car. And talking about the TCU, now that I mentioned it, I really enjoy this TCU map. It's so snappy and so sharp. The TCU remap complements the Stage 2 ECU remap really well, because it's so snappy, so agile and so lively. Even though the DQ200 gearbox is quite a snappy gearbox from factory, they've managed to make it rather nice, and it is very responsive too. But is it worth it? That's up to you. If you have a 1.5 TSI Evo sitting downstairs in a Virtus, go for it. I would say it's a decent upgrade, and it definitely does change the behavior of the car, allowing you to have some extra more fun and involvement while enjoying a couple of twisties like I'm just getting to experience. And you would not regret it. Now, if you get the chance to experience a 1.5 TSI Evo in a Virtus, definitely try it, because it is a world apart from a 1-liter TSI. Yes, it is still in its constricted form, and if you get the chance to drive a 1.5 TSI Evo with a Stage 2 tune, you will definitely know what I'm talking about, because it is a really nice car to drive, but it's still the same little block with a little bit more fitness, in my opinion. I'm actually glad that finally this platform is picking up, and we are going to get to see better and bigger upgrades into the Virtus lineup and the MQB A0 India platform. So what are your thoughts on the Virtus GT, and do you guys know any more secrets about how they have managed to do this? Do let us know in the comments down below, and if you've got any questions, shoot away. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.